Hello guys, once again you all are welcome in my channel. Today on the request of several of my subscriber, I come up with one topic, you know, what are the various areas where we can use IoT and what are the various research areas where one can, you know, pursue their PhD or masters or make their projects. So I come up with some novel ideas, you know, where you can make your projects or can start your career doing PhD in that particular area, particularly in IoT. So in IoT, I think I am not, you know, going into the detail. IoT stands for Internet of Things. Everybody aware about this particular word. So in IoT, the very, very first research area where you can, you know, pursue your career is smart cities. Now, if we are talking about the smart cities, it means, you know, to make cities, villages, and campuses. In fact, the campus means your own college campus. You can make it IoT enabled and smart to provide a quality culture. So some of the research areas in these domains are like, if I'm saying, the mainly you can, you know, make some home appliances, managing or monitoring system using artificial intelligence algorithm to take care and manage home appliances to provide secure and efficient smart home to the people. So this is the one thing where you can, you know, create something, some appliances to make these devices more suitable for, which can ease the life of the person. So this is the one area, means you can go for some household devices which can automate all the process. So this is one. The second one is the application of IoT in business. So if you see, due to the recent advancement in technology, every business is today more or less based on IoT things. So there is a need of, you know, huge research in this particular area. So how to make the business easy? Like if I'll give you some example, like the development of and implementation of, you know, some sort of model or architect for optimizing efficiency and employee productivity. Like in India, Indian private market or, you know, public sector, they want to optimize the operational efficiency of an employee. And how you can do it? So there are several, you know, subdomains. We can think, you know, how to make this employability productive. So this is one very, very important area where you can use IoT for business perspective. If we are talking about the industry automation, so by implementing, you know, some industry specific parameter in order, in particular order, or so that its productivity of the product as well as the employees both increases. So if you come up with some, you know, sort of IoT application which will, you know, increase not only the productivity in the terms of product but also the employee, so this can be another feature where you can use IoT. If we are talking about energy, so IoT, through the IoT you can also, you know, make some energy efficient devices, where because energy is nowadays a very big problem, and with the upcoming era, and you know, as the population goes on increases, so energy is one of the prime issue, will be become a prime issue in the future. So you can do something to, you know, save the energy with the help of IoT devices, or by monitoring them and, you know, by switching off them in a proper interval. So this kind of thinking you can be, in this kind of devices you can be think of. In the same way, the IoT technology in GIS based information system to manage all the natural resources such as rain, water, soil, in order to improve the condition of the farming, agriculture and the village conditions. You can come up with some sort of devices which can be, automate these processes and through which you can save the natural resources like rainwater and soil like this, and you can help in the agriculture sector also. One very important research area is IoT, since, IoT means Internet of Things and everything get automated. So security is one of the prime aspect. So how to then, go for the security? So as the IoT applications are growing day by day, in the same intensity, IoT threats and attacks are also increasing. So there is a need of, some mechanism, some sort of mechanism which can be, or which must be secure and which can prevent the attacks on IoT devices. And IoT security threat to secure data accessed from IoT devices, because if we are using, regularly some IoT devices, so there are a lot of data generated. So you have to prevent that data also, not only that device. We want to, prevent that data. If that data get breached out, then it also creates some problem. So in IoT, we have a dual challenge. Not only in case of, protecting our device by putting some passwords, but also to protect the real-time data whatsoever we are using. And because if somebody has a tap on that particular data, means how regularly you are using that particular thing, so definitely your privacy get breached. So this is again a very hot topic where you can do something. So IoT, and one more area of concern is IoT in health sector or pharmaceutical industry. There is a huge need of IoT technology and its solution for the pharmaceutical industry. As if you heard about the name AML, that is ambient intelligence. So it requires a lot of, IoT changes. So if you have a little bit, I'll create a one more video in which I will, state what is this AML. So there is a need to research and find solutions for all the problems, in particular better facility to people and make their life better. So in research, if we are talking about IoT solution for pharmaceutical industry, we should have to be, have come up with some sort of diagnosis or monitoring system which can be developed using machine learning or AI algorithm. I already, worked on these areas on health sectors. If you people need some guidance how to, make some novel IoT devices on the basis of this technology, you can consult me anytime. We can, work together and make some good projects. Another area is blockchain Internet of Things. So blockchain is a recent area that is growing rapidly, that is comparatively based on the Internet of Things. There is a need to do a research in the domain to create trust in the blockchain application in the public. So some very important topic, in which we are using IoT with blockchain. So if you have ever experience of, implementing the blockchain, so you can implement the same thing in the IoT devices and make it more secure. So this is again one of the very important area. So I talked about, several research topics like blockchain, Internet of Things solutions, and the Internet of Things healthcare, Internet of Things for analytics, IoT and cybersecurity, IoT for waste management, IoT for farming, IoT for agriculture, IoT for campuses, cities and villages. So these are the areas, where you can come up with the products or some sort of new designs which can be helpful for the society. So and I am, already started working in this area, not now, but I'm from the last 5 years, I am continuously working for IoT devices. So if you have any novel idea, or you want to, something, or you want some guidance in particularly in IoT field, you can contact me anytime. My email ID, my mobile number are given in the description below. So you just go and, and call me anytime. And in case you have any idea where you get stuck and you do not know, how to proceed, so you can consult me anytime. I am, very happy to, help you people out. So with this note, I am ending this video over here. We'll come back soon with new innovative video. Till then, stay tuned. Bye-bye. Thank you.